Friends, we are going to demonstrate how to prepare velvet beans as a vegetable to be used for various dishes. What you see here, a set of velvet beans pods we collected from our garden upstairs. You will see these velvet beans are either a bit green or getting yellowish. These yellowish ones are very ripe and are now turning to become dry pods. They can also be cooked. The green ones are the easier one to cook. We have mixed both here so that you can see how to handle both of them. You can also cook dry velvet beans kernels. In velvet beans, the edible part is the kernels inside. The outside skin will not be edible at all. This is a velvet beans of white seeds variety. You can also eat velvet beans of black seeds variety. But the black seeds variety is slightly more towards the wild variety. So people who may have stomach allergy for velvet beans need to be more careful with the black beans inside than the white beans inside. This is the white beans inside. So this is very mild variety. And so far I have not heard anybody complaining from the circle I know. So unfortunately, this needs some preparation before we can cook, and once we prepare it well, it will serve as a very delicious vegetable. We are going to wash this first in water, and then we are going to cut open these pods. We have the pods washed. Before cutting the pods, we need to apply any cooking oil. This is a coconut oil we have to our palms. This is because the pods, when we cut open, they give out sap. That sap makes our fingers very black, and that black color may not vanish so easily. So now I'm going to cut this pod. So idea is to remove the kernel. So cut the pod open like this. When you cut the pods open, you can see the kernels. So these are the white kernels. You can see the white kernels. Separate the white kernels. These kernels is what we need, and the rest of the parts not edible. So this we are going to discard. So this I cut from a bit yellow colored one that is very ripe. Basically this is a bit more younger and tender. Open. So this is a bit tender one. You can see the size of the kernel is a bit smaller. So this is how you separate the kernels. After we have cut all the pods, you can see the skins that will be discarded. Now you may see different colors here. Need not worry, because we are not going to use the outer skin of these kernels. These skins can be removed after soaking them in water for 24 hours. Even then, if they don't come after cooking them, they will definitely come. So please remember to discard the skins of the kernel. And as you can see, look at my hand. Even after coconut oil, my thumb is a bit darker. Maybe I didn't apply enough coconut oil. If your hand becomes dark with black color, need not worry. After a couple of washes, it will just go off. It's just for cosmetic reasons you want to avoid this black color. Otherwise, there is nothing to worry. Now these kernels now need to be soaked in water. So I'm adding them to the water. So you just soak them for 24 hours. You soak them in water for 24 hours. They become further softer, and the water might become a bit colored, and it may even get a bit soapy texture. You will discard that water and cook it with the fresh water after 24 hours. If you are using a dry pod, then the kernels may need up to 72 hours of soaking. Every 24 hours, you will just change the water so that these kernels can give away all the unwanted chemicals not suitable for cooking. Now, as you can see that these pods are actually are the hybrid variety or the farm variety. These are mild in their medicinal content, so more suitable as vegetables. The ideal velvet beans for medicinal purpose are the wild variety, but they are extremely difficult to handle because they have millions of micro bristles on their skin, and they can be very irritating to the skin, and you will be needing doctor's help to deal with such an accident of touching with wild varieties of pods. Wild varieties of pods are best suited for medicinal purpose, primarily the Parkinson's disease. They are well suited to make a decoction of the dry kernels like coffee beans. Also, they can be cooked for very potent medicine. This one will have very milder medicinal quality and more suitable as a vegetable. Some people may have stomach allergy, so you may have to test yourself with a very small quantity, that too by handling it properly like shown here. So now we are going to leave this for 24 hours. Then we are going to discard the water, cook it in the cooker, separate the kernels from their skins. Then we will be ready to use them as vegetable. We can put them in special rice like palau. We can use them in sambar, or we can use them also in curry. Very tasty vegetable once you know how to handle it. After 24 hours of soaking, it is time to change the water and cook these kernels. So I am going to remove these kernels from this old water and adding it to a cooker utensil with fresh water. You don't need to worry about the skin at this stage. After cooking, we will peel the skin out. Now, looking at the old water, you can see that some color is left behind. So that shows that some unwanted taste and chemicals are left behind, increasing the taste of the kernels. Now we are going to cook this. After it is cooked, we are going to filter the water out using a strainer. So now you can see that the skin of the kernel comes out very fast. We are going to discard this skin and use only the white kernel. For those of you who still have some fear of allergy, you can cook this further using turmeric powder. Turmeric powder is an excellent insurance in Indian cooking against any toxins. So with this, now we can use this kernel as a vegetable. We can use it for special rice, we can use it for sambar, we can use it for curry, etc. So we just separate this and discard this kernel skins. What we will be left with is something white beans kernel.